A disturbing and recent trend across Hampton Roads is our top story at 5. 3 cases of missing women.
The most recent came in today. Suffolk police are looking for a woman they consider to be in danger. 40-year-old Eunice Cho. Her name is now added to the list that already includes Katie Barham from Portsmouth and Brianna Armstrong from Chesapeake.
And police have found Armstrong's body. Tonight we have team coverage. Deanna LeBlanc is in Virginia Beach, where today police arrested a suspect in Armstrong's death. Jason Marks is in Portsmouth, where investigators found a body near the apartment where Barham was last seen. We start with Deanna.
Yeah, Tom and Nicole, Justin Cornell, the 38-year-old, will spend the next few nights in the jail behind me. His lawyer has requested a bond hearing for Friday. That's the same day that a family friend tells us the Armstrongs are planning a private funeral for Brianna Armstrong. Today, neighbors we spoke with say they had no idea why there was a police presence yesterday at their apartment complex. And when they heard the news, they were shocked. Justin Cornell appeared briefly before a judge in Virginia Beach today. Today we worked to know more about the man accused of murdering a good friend. His neighbors say they didn't really know him.
I say he was a gentleman that was quiet. He came and went. If you had him in a lineup, I wouldn't be able to recognize him because he just kept to himself.
I talked to him when he'd be going to the dumpster. I'd be, good morning. And that's about it, because if you don't speak to him, he will not speak to you.
Court papers show Cornell has no ties to our area, that he moved to the area 2 years ago, but spent many years in Florida. Now, these women say they're on edge.
Scared. I'm scared.
Both watched police arrive late Tuesday afternoon, but say the presence was small and calm. One neighbor describes Cornell sitting in his own vehicle for hours before being placed in handcuffs. Police have since towed away his car.
And around 11 o'clock, they came out from inspecting his unit, and they put some trash bags that looked like trash bags in their forensics unit car. The police came out, touched this man up and down, and put handcuffs on him, brought him over here, and took him away.
Justin Cornell's front door is just half a mile from where Brianna Armstrong's car was found abandoned in early May. Shoes, wallet, keys still inside.
That's creepy. I got a murderer across the street. You know, I mean, there's literally right across the street that I've spoke to. Who would ever thought?
Now these women have one question, and the answer may be hard to find.
Why? What did she do to you that was so bad you had to take her life?
Now, as we mentioned, Cornell and Armstrong were co-workers and close friends. They both worked as massage therapists until Cornell apparently got upset over another person's promotion and was let go in mid-May, according to his boss. Hear from that boss on what he remembers of Brianna Armstrong and how he helped search for her and what he thinks of Justin Cornell coming up tonight at 6. Live in Virginia Beach, I'm Deanna LeBlanc, 10 on your side.
38-year-old Justin Cornell faced a Virginia Beach judge this afternoon in connection with the killing of his co-worker, Brianna Armstrong. Her remains were found in a remote area of Chesapeake weeks after she was reported missing. Then at your side, Deanna LeBlanc talked with the manager of the message company they both work for.
Massage company. And Deanna, what did you find out?
Well, Tom and Nicole, Cornell's co-workers tell me that both he and the victim, Brianna Armstrong, were loved by their clients and good at their jobs. They say hearing this news really breaks their heart twice because they considered everyone that they worked with like family. Now, all they want to know in the manager's words is what made Cornell snap and why he felt he had to take someone's life.
Our heads are just spinning on the whole thing.
Knuckles and Knots regional manager Mark Harris says both of his employees, Justin Cornell and Brianna Armstrong, kept their relationship private, but says he doesn't believe it was romantic.
We knew that they were close friends, but yeah, he never really crossed our minds as a possible suspect.
Harris says Cornell and Armstrong worked at separate locations, but sometimes worked shifts at the same location. He says he never had any problems with Cornell.
In fact, his clients all really liked him. He was very highly requested as a therapist.
But Cornell recently got upset over another person's promotion, and Harris let him go on May 12th, 3 days after Brianna was last seen.
All of us are looking back and thinking, you know, what could, is there anything that could have indicated that this was a possibility? What could, is there anything that we could have done?
Harris, who organized search parties and a vigil, says the hardest part now is knowing police believe Armstrong may have been held captive for a few days before her death.
We organized search party after they found her car. but could we have tried harder to find her? Could we have prevented this?
Harris hopes through all the ugliness of the crime, people remember the good that Brianna brought to all of their lives.
When we had a vigil for Brianna on Sunday, we wanted to make sure that people remembered kindness and that we needed to be kind to each other, as she was always so kind to all of us.
And Cornell now faces second-degree murder charges, but it's not uncommon in situations like this for charges to be upgraded as the case continues to develop. Now, Cornell does have a bond hearing scheduled here in Virginia Beach for Friday. That's the same day that a family friend tells us the Armstrongs are planning a private memorial service for Brianna. Live in Virginia Beach, I'm Deanna LeBlanc, 10 on your side.